After flying for a private air taxi company in Nigeria, which went bust, I joined Bristow Helicopters out there, and they immediately sent me back to UK, did a 3 months helicopter conversion, and ended up on the 61 in Aberdeen. You never know what's going to happen next with Bristow. But they're good, and a very professional company. This is on the Beryl Alpha, 200 miles north of Aberdeen, out in the North Sea. Took 2 hours to get there in the 61. Nice, steady old bus. Weather today is beautiful, quite a rare event in the North Sea. There's the guy who's going to do the refueling, all dressed up. Those are the fuel tanks. They're portable, and they're changed by barge and crane. You'll see that later. Calm sea down there. There's a lifeboat. Safety first. And the drilling rig itself. Okay, there's the fuel tanks being transferred. This is back on the Brent, in the Brent field. That's an empty one going on board the supply ship, and they'll bring some full ones up. There's no way you could connect a hose for refueling, as you can understand. These guys really earn their pay. Pretty hairy job at times. I'm watching from the safety of the heli deck. Again, another bright, shiny day. Didn't happen very often, but I always got the camera out when it happened. So, once or twice every 2 years. Anyway, there goes the supply ship. He's done his job, and we'll show some flying clips next. I got transferred to the 212s offshore. And we lived on the treasure finder attached to the Brent Bravo. This is coming into one of the accommodation rigs in the Brent field. The drilling platform in the background. If the wind was coming from the direction of the platform, it made for very gusty conditions and interesting landings. There's the treasure hunter, sister accommodation platform for the treasure find. This is the Cabilonga ship operated by the Italians to provide diving services. Sunset scene on the North Sea. Overcast, threatening snow. Flying at night in snow was pretty dodgy. Read my book and it will explain why. 212 on the treasure finder. My afternoon off, I did the morning shift. Normally about 3 hours. You stayed in the cockpit all that time. Rotors running, refueling, and uploading and offloading of passengers. All done with rotors running. Save time. Here comes a British Airways 61. Shell didn't like to give all the contracts to one helicopter company. Like to encourage competition. Keep the price down, I suppose. Yeah, nice weather again, but I wasn't going to film in the bad weather because the rain and the mist kept getting on the lens. Most of the time we had about 30 knots of wind blowing, which gave you good payloads for takeoff. The calm days like this, payloads could be restricted. There you go. Coming to the end, that's the Brent Bravo. Immense. Huge rigs. There's our hangar doors, closed at the moment. And that's it. Thank you.